How did the idea of Dr. Vaidya come to your mind?
Sure, yeah, so look, I think a lot of people think Dr. Vaidya is a startup. And the reality is, it is a startup, but it had a lot of backstory behind it, right? So Vaidya, my last name, means Ayurvedic doctor. I come from a legacy of 150 years of Ayurveda in my family. My grandfather, great-grandfather, and generation four were all Ayurvedic doctors. My great-grandfather actually moved from Morbi in Gujarat to Bombay in 1923, set up a small Ayurvedic clinic. And in 1957, my dada graduated from college. He, like was customary at the time, he studied medicine, became an Ayurvedic doctor, joined his father. And in 71, his father retired. He took on the practice. By the 80s and 90s, my dada became one of India's most successful Ayurvedic doctors. He saw 300 to 350 patients a day in his clinic. He had 12,000 patients on a monthly basis trying to buy a post from across India. And post, you'll imagine, is the e-commerce of that time. In the late 80s, my dad graduated from college. And he was not a doctor. He wanted to make a brand out of Dr. Vaidya's. He said, what my grandfather was doing for hundreds and thousands of patients in the clinic, he wanted to take that to millions of people across India. And FMCG brands were just being built at that time. It was the beginning of FMCG in India. So my dad said, look, we can build a brand out of it.
This was in which year?
Late 80s. So they tried to work together for a year. But eventually my grandfather didn't understand why he has to pay for sales, marketing, distribution. There are so many people coming into the team, why does he have to pay? And so eventually they tried to work together for a year and it didn't work out. My dad eventually went his own way and now has run a successful business in jewelry and watches for the last 35 years. I grew up with asthma, right? So I was born in 91 and I suffered from juvenile bronchitis. I grew up with pumps, nebulizers, inhalers, steroids. I was telling you before we started that I'm a huge cricket fan. I went to play cricket at Hindu Gymkhana when I was 5 years old. By the time I was 7, my grandfather moved me off the cricket field because there was too much dust on the cricket field. And so I was the only kid playing golf and squash while everyone else was playing cricket and football. When we were growing up, and today it's different, when we were growing up, Coca-Cola, Limca, Fanta, Sprite, these were like typically what kids would have at birthday parties, right? I was the only kid who wasn't allowed to have it because of my asthma. I did not have ice cream till I was 12 years old. And the first time I went to Baskin-Robbins, my parents got me a scoop of vanilla ice cream, waited till it melted, and then let me have the soup because it was too cold, it would jack my throat and I'd start wheezing, right? So that was the childhood I grew up with. And my grandfather said that Ayurveda can cure this, right? But 13, 14 years of treatment later, by the time I was 15 and a half years old, he cured me of asthma. I used my last pump, I've not used a pump since. And I started playing cricket again. And when I was 16 and a half, I wrote about this on LinkedIn as well. I became cricket captain of my school cricket team. It wasn't the biggest team. There weren't that many people who wanted to play. I went to an IB school, so it wasn't as serious a team. But for me, it was a big stepping stone in my life. And Ayurveda had given me this. So at that time, I made a promise to my granddad that I want to do something with this legacy. That's the backstory behind why I started this company after he passed away.
You quit a job of 30 lakh per annum, which is very huge for ordinary Indian individual guy who want to start something on his or her own. So like, risk appetite is very important in entrepreneur's journey. Many people told me also that take calculated risk in your life, but I never understood how one can take a calculated risk in their life. Can you explain me like how to take a calculated risk or why?
Like life is all about opportunity cost, right? Huh. I'm here spending time with you. Had I not been doing this podcast, I have the opportunity to do something else with my time, right? And so everything in life is about opportunity cost. Every risk you take has an opportunity cost attached to it, right? And so basically all decision making of founders, all decision making in our lives is all about opportunity cost. If you get married today, the other option is don't get married. If you are having a child today, the other option is don't have a child. If you're starting a business today, the other option is don't start a business and continue your job, right? But for me, at that time when I quit my job, I said, look, I'm 24 and a half years old. My ex-boss actually told me, there are only two times you can start a business. At 25 when you have a little bit of experience, or at 50 when you have no responsibility. And in between, it's going to be really hard for you to start a business, right? And so that time I said, look, I promised my dad I'll do something with it. He's passed away. There is potential in this. And worst case, what will happen? Like, I'll fail, right? But at 24, 25, like, if I become hugely successful, that's just bonus for me. I'm expected to fail, right? So anything better than this is great. Again, I'm saying it sounds very easy because now I've built something out of it. And it's difficult for anyone to keep failing, and our first year was really tough. But for me at that time, I said, look, like, there is potential in this. I believe in it. I'm cured of it. I promised my grandfather, I have to do it. What's the worst that can happen? I'll fail. So
I think people don't have that acceptance of that worst outcome.
No, so I'll tell you another thing, right? So while I was building my business, I have a family business, right? Jewelry and watches that my dad has built. It's a pretty sizable business. And very well known, right? So a lot of people would come to me during that time and say, your father has such a good business. Why are you wasting your time doing this? Nothing's going to happen with this, etc. All of that. And that's not easy, right? Like, because I'm not doing well, clearly. It's really difficult for me. And then you're coming and saying, join your father's business. What are you wasting your time doing all of this, right? I'll tell you, those same people, when Dr. Vaidya's became a success, came to me and said, you're such a smart and hardworking guy. I always knew you'd be a success. I was telling this person that he's going to make something out of it, right? So I think when you take the risk, right, you will have many naysayers, but huge amount of self-belief is important. And I think for that, it was not only self-belief in me, it was family support as well, because it's a tough journey. It's a lot of ups and downs. The ups are amazing, but the downs, like, you need support system. And I think we were fortunate that my father was an entrepreneur and I had really good family support from my brother, my mom, my wife who was in it with me, my dad, my grandmother who was still alive. Yeah, amazing support.